Hello, champions! I'm the first red player in this game, and I see what I've got. I got your spawn, I could go for two-pawn hold British Empire, plus I could also expand into Iceland as well, guys. I've got plus 4 troops in Scandinavia, so I could use those to basically immediately capture both of those continents. Wow. So let's add my troops over here. Let's go. Let's use those troops, guys. 100% blitzes. And yes! That is a good turn. Pawn, guys. And to which border should I fortify my troops to? Well, let's fortify them to Scotland. So in case somebody breaks for London, then at the very least I would be able to hold Iceland. Let's accept alliance request sent by the blue player. Let's send him a thumbs up. Let's send alliance request to the rest of the players as well, guys. And let's see if we can win with this. Got our spawn. Turn 1, noob corner. Here we go. My next goal would be to expand into either Scandinavia or into France. One of those two bonuses, guys. The white player goes into the Russian Empire. Fortifies strips like that. What about pink? Pink player has a good spawn in the Narek Alps. I would definitely go for the Narek Alps if I was with pink player. And then in the next turn I would consider expanding into Southeastern Europe too. Let's send a thumbs up for the white player. The white player has accepted my alliance request. And then the pink and purple players do not know yet whether we want to be my allies or not. And then the yellow player is a player who didn't ready up. He was replaced by a neutral AI bot. Well, the pink player said he had enough of it, guys. He saw I got two amazing stars and he just surrenders. Not officially, but after 10 minutes he will go MIA and take the last available place. The purple player adds his troops and left, so will he go for the Narek Alps since the pink player didn't? Let's go. Two border continents and right here. Those blizzards even defend him from the left side of the map. The yellow neutral AI just stacks its troops. What about blue now? The blue player has the majority of his troops spawn over here, so will he go for North Africa, will he go for Southeastern Europe, or will he go for a completely different part of the map? Here is the biggest question. Alright, the purple player accepts my alliance request. Let's send him a thumbs up. Let's be friends. It's good to be allied with strong players. Right here, the blue player adds his troops in Jordan, plus 3 troops in Benghazi as well. Alright, captures a territory of mine, fortifies his troops, and that's it. Which continent should I go for myself, guys? Should I expand to Western Europe or Scandinavia? I kind of want to wipe out the purple player from over here, guys, because of that reason I'm going for this continent over here. Let's go. Right here, we'll say sorry, but I need to attack your territory, purple. I want to wipe you out. You're the strongest player, the only other player who got a continent, so I do not want you being next to me at all, sir. Alright, let's fortify my free troop army like that, guys. Could have made 3 versus 1 attack, but it would have been 89% blitz, guys. I could have risked losing those troops, so because of that reason, I'm going to take over Denmark next turn. It isn't a part of Scandinavia, but it will shrink my borders by 1. White player right here sent me a thumbs up. He approves me taking over Scandinavia. And right here, he goes for the Russian Empire himself, guys. For I wouldn't appreciate it if he captures it immediately. Ideally, I would like to snowball this game by myself alone. Alright, and fortifies his troops like that. The purple player still has a territory in Berlin, guys, in case he wants to attack me. But at the very least, I wipe him out from Scandinavia, so it's much harder for him to do something to me. He strengthens both of those borders good. If he doesn't expand into another continent, then I will be very happy for sure, guys. I will try to dominate this map by myself. I mean, if I additionally take over Alps, France, and Central Europe, then with those blizzards, I would be able to hold 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 continents under 3 borders to God, which would be Gascony, Prussia, and Finland. And then I additionally could expand into Andalusia without shrinking my borders, and then even to Nalot, because right here, with that blizzard, Italy split, and Trieste doesn't connect to Rome. Wow, I really see the winning plan already, guys. Will I be able to execute my strategy for? Here is the biggest question, because those players could obviously team up on 13 troops received by me, guys. What I am going to... Well, for now, let's go for the French Empire, because if I take over Central Europe, I would be bordering purple. I do not want to be bordering purple. Let's attack the yellow bot over here. It just keeps stacking more troops, something what I do not like at all. Let's attack over here, guys. Do not need to defend against the yellow neutral inactivity AI, so I'm fortifying my troops like that. Let's go. Also, I forgot to take over Denmark, but oh well, right here, let's send a thumbs up for the white player, who I would be really tempted to attack, guys. So should I try neutralizing the biggest threat, guys? see Midler not well. White player doesn't take over Russian Empire. He still waits. He still waits for something to happen. Guys, maybe I should attack purple. Ideally, the purple player adds his troops somewhere right here, guys. Doesn't leave a bunch of troops to defend his borders and then basically wipe him out. Do I even have a set? No, I do not. It would have been really helpful, guys. In this map, you should really snowball if you want to win. So I definitely want to attack those players, but come on, too. The purple player lost a single troop attacking a four troop army of a yellow bot, but to be fair, I only lost one troop doing the same in the French Empire as well, guys. Okay, attack purple, the white player says. Yeah, I have to really think about it, guys. It okay, MIA, the pink player goes MIA, guys. I'm really considering attacking purple and then neutralizing the white player as well after he takes the Russian Empire. Ideally, I would like to dominate this Giba myself. But let's see what does the blue player do, guys. If the blue player breaks for Greece, then basically he does the dirty work for me. Alright, he captures, the blue player captures a territory of mine, guys. The blue player trusts me the least, guys. If he got an opportunity to betray me, to attack me, then he would do so. I mean, if he get a strong position or if other players strongly attack me, guys. Yeah, so should I do it, guys? Should I do this thing? Well, why not, guys? Let's attack the purple over here, guys. Let's break that alliance. Let's take the attacker's advantage on both armies over here. Let's go. Alright, good. Good, good. And right here, can we wipe him out from over here as well? Let's go, guys. Alright, a thumbs up for that, guys. And let's see if I can dominate this game myself alone. Yes, the purple player surrenders, guys, raises a white flag. Basically, blue and white players are left. So in this case, I could even consider giving the white player the second place, guys, because he has been a good ally. Right? The purple player has been a good ally as well, guys, but I couldn't let him dominate the game to balance me out, guys. Right here, the white player doesn't break from me. Let's send him a thumbs up. I want to give him the second place and destroy blue, who has been targeting territories of mine over here. Right, he doesn't have a set. Good for us. Please waste a bunch of troops, because this way I can just eliminate you from the game immediately, sir. Yes. Please take over this continent. Let's go. Let's go. Well, I do not have an easy access to Mascara, unfortunately. Alright, but basically, yes. Let's trade in a set, guys. Or should I? I do not want to trade in a 6th set, guys. Well, let's attack. Let's attack a blue player without trading in a set, guys. Let's go. Alright. Let's split my troops like that. How many troops should I split, guys? Right, I guess like that. Go attacking those territories. Okay, slider blitz mistake, guys. Should be stealing my troops. Let's go. Let's go into West Africa. Over here as well, the blue player raises a white flag as well, guys. I get his cards. And yes, well played, the white player says. Let's trade in two sets at once. Okay, a thumbs up. I will see. Thanks, and I'm going to be after those bots, guys. I will honor the alliance with the white player. Alright, well, let's eliminate the purple player over here as well. Let's go. We will trade in another set over here. Good. And right here, let's go just to capture as many territories or stuff as possible, guys. Let's wipe out those players from over here. And let's fortify that army right here. Alright, thumbs up, please. Attack yellow, please. Attack pink. You can attack me as well, but basically you're losing white. Looking at your troop counter, you're so weak. Yes, a heart for you, sir. You're going to get the alliance victory, aka this second place. 52 troops received by me, guys. Let's add more troops over here. Let's add more troops over here. Let's add more troops over here as well, guys. Let's add the rest of my troops right here. Let's proceed doing with blitzes. Let's eliminate the pink and yellow players from the game. First of all, starting with yellow, because he's in the way, and then we're eliminating the pink player as well. Let's go, guys. Alright, thanks. Good game, well played, and a heart for you. Let's go blitzing your army over here, but basically we still have to wait, guys, another turn. Let's fortify my 7 troops like that. The white player adds more troops to Moscow. He trades in a set. Will he simply skip his turn? And yes, with keys, guys, that is the keys. But wow, guys, the Gotham spawn basically immediately won us the game. Wow, the spawn was just incredible. Wow, Gotham spawn for sure. What a nice and sweet victory for us, guys. Let's go.